वेलकम टू ऑल माय बिलव्ड स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी विल लेक्चर्स ऑन द कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स व्हिच इज इन योर सिलेबस इन यूनिट टू ऑन फूड केमिस्ट्री वन. माइसेल्फ पार्थसारथी पंडित. आई एम लेक्चरर इन एफपीटी फ्रॉम शेखपाड़ा एआरएम पॉलिटेक्निक. द कोर्स ऑब्जेक्टिव of this topic is the main objective is to students with different chemical interactions and reaction of food components and their effects on sensory, nutritional and functional properties of foods and how processing influences their properties. The course outcome or course objective of this topic is to the students will be understand after completing course the structure and compositions of the different nutrients, demonstrate the physical and chemical properties of different nutrients, recognize the function of the nutrient in different food materials and their practical implications, apply fundamental concept to know principle behind analytical techniques associated with the foods. Now, the learning outcomes of this topic is to, after completing the topics, the students will be get to able understand the identification of food content carbohydrates, definition of carbohydrates, classification of carbohydrates, physicochemical properties of carbohydrates, describe the nutritional and clinical significance of carbohydrates, and outline the application of carbohydrate in foods. Now, first of all, we have to know what is the foods and what is the nutrition. We are all know about the food is a material consisting essentially of protein, carbohydrate, and fat that is called nutrient. Used in the body of an organism to sustain growth, repair and vital process and to furnish energy, such materials together with supplementary substance like mineral, vitamin and condiments, etc. Now, the nutrition is the another part that is the science of foods, the nutrient and other substance. They are in action, interaction and balancing in relation to health and disease. Now come to the point, that is the carbohydrate parts. What is carbohydrate? We know all about the photosynthesis process, where carbohydrates are produced in this process. In the reaction take place between the carbon dioxide and water present in sunlight. It present in almost all type of foods. Some of it may be simple molecules like sugar, which are water soluble. Other are complex and large molecules like starch, cellulose, etc. Now, the source of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are widely distributed in all the living organisms. If you see, this is the two parts, that is the starch parts and cellulose parts. Starch parts means it is a stored form, and cellulose is the structural parts. It's simple sugar or glucose in present in fruits. Sucrose, the sugar used in every household, in obtained as a sugar cane or sugar beet. The amount of carbohydrate in animal is much lesser as compared to the in that in plant molecules. These are present primarily in the form of glucose and glycogen. Glycogen is the source of carbohydrate in animal. Lactose is a type of carbohydrate also called the milk sugar present in milk. Some example of the carbohydrate secreted of many microorganisms includes xanthan gum and jelal gum, etc. In every day, we take foods in different food items, but if you see, all the food items must contain the carbohydrate parts. Like, if we take in dairy, milk, yogurt, ice cream, it contain carbohydrate. If we take fruit or vegetables, it contain carbohydrate. If we take grains, legumes, all are contain carbohydrate. Now, the structure of carbohydrates. The name suggested that carbohydrate means carbon and hydrate. Hydrate means H2O or water molecule. Water molecule means H2O means H plus and OH minus. When H plus and OH minus is attached to carbon atoms, it form a glycans, and or we can say that it is the hydrate of carbons. That means carbohydrate means hydrate of carbons. Now, the structure of carbohydrates, so you have to know what come from this carbohydrates. The parent molecule is glycerol. The structure is CH2OH, CHOH, CH2OH. This glycerol compound, when oxidized, it produces glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetones. In glyceraldehyde, it contains aldehyde groups, that means CHO group, and dihydroxyacetones, it contains a keto group or C double bond O group. Now, carbohydrates containing an aldehyde, it is called glyceraldehyde, is an aldotriosis, that means in aldose with C carbon atoms. When it is ketose, it contains keto form, and that means dihydroxyacetones is a ketotriosis, a ketones with a C carbon atoms. Now, the depends on the carbon atoms, we can classify it in various forms like allotriosis, allotetosis, aldopentosis, aldohexosis. That is, if we see the main structures of the part of the glyceraldehyde and dihydroxyacetones, one CHO group present and one C double bond O group present at the C2 carbon. If we consider the glyceraldehyde parts at C2 carbon, here is right side position is OH group and left side is H groups. When if we interchanging each others, this then it forms a isomers, and this carbon is called asymmetric carbon. And when we will interchange each others and it forms isomers, and depends on the number of carbon atoms, allotriosis is produced two isomers. If we see the structure of dihydroxyacetones in C2 carbons, it is one keto group. That's why we cannot interchange each others. That means one isomer is produced. Now, if we consider the and we consider when the carbon atom is four number of carbon atoms, it produces allotetosis, and at when the carbon atom is 5, it aldopentosis. When carbon atom is 6, it aldohexosis. Similarly, when carbon atom is 4, it's ketotetrosis, then 8 is ketopentosis, and 16 it's ketohexosis. Now, the glyceraldehyde carbon, if we switch the structure of the glyceraldehyde, we see the D glyceraldehyde and L glyceraldehyde. First of all, we have to know what is the chiral carbon or chiral centers. A chiral carbon means a carbon atom which attached in four different functional group is called chiral carbon or chiral centers. Now, the structure of glyceraldehyde, where we can see the OH group at the right hand side. That's why we can say this is the D glyceraldehyde. When this OH group in left hand side is called the L glyceraldehyde. Now, the arrangement of atoms in carbohydrate in their simple linear form contains a chain of carbon atoms in which, except one, all the carbon atoms carry one OH group each. One carbon atom carries a carbonyl group. The carbonyl group may be located at the end of the carbon chain as an aldehyde or inside the chain as ketone group. These chains can have 3 to 100 of carbon atoms. On the basis of this arrangement of atoms and groups, carbohydrates are defined as polyhydroxides, polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones, or the substance which gives aldehyde or ketones on breakdown. Glucose, the most common simple carbohydrate, is a polyhydroxyaldehyde, while fructose is a polyhydroxy ketone. Now, the classification of carbohydrates, the classification of carbohydrates is classified on the basis of the two parts, that is the molecular size or degree of polarization, and another part is digestive fats. On the basis of the degree of polarization, carbohydrate is classified into four groups, that is monosaccharide, disaccharide, oligosaccharide and polysaccharides. Monosaccharide means it contains one single unit of monosaccharide or sugar atoms. The simple is glucose, galactose is the monosaccharide. Disaccharide, it consists of two units of monosaccharides, this is called disaccharide. Lactose, sucrose is a disaccharide. Now oligosaccharide, when each molecule contains of 3 to 9 monosaccharide units is called oligosaccharides. Paraffin is an example of oligosaccharides. Now the polysaccharides, if the molecule contain more than 9 units is called the polysaccharides. Starch, cellulose, it is called the polysaccharides. Now classification is based on digestive fat of carbohydrates. The digestive fat of carbohydrate depends on their inherent chemical natures, on the supermolecular structure within foods of which they are part. Carbohydrates classified in available and unavailable. Classified carbohydrates that are digested to constituent monosaccharides and absorbed fall under the category of available carbohydrates. Carbohydrates that are not digested by the endogenous enzyme of the human intestinal tract and therefore not absorbed are classified as unavailable carbohydrate. Now, what is the monosaccharide? Monosaccharide sugar are also called simple carbohydrate and consist of monosaccharides and disaccharides. The monosaccharide consists of single polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketone unit that cannot be hydrolyzed into smaller size units. If we see the number of carbon atoms, the monosaccharide can be classified into another groups like triosis, tetrosis, pentosis, hexosis. In triosis, there is 3 carbon atoms, tetrosis is the 4 carbon atoms, pentosis 5 carbon atoms, and hexosis is 6 carbon atoms. The example of monosaccharide is glucose. Is the general formula is C6H12O6 and the structure is alpha glucose and beta glucose. Now fructose, it is the another example of monosaccharide, also called as fruit sugar. It is the ketonic monosaccharides found in many plants. It combine state with glucose, it gives a disaccharide sucrose. Sucrose, glucose plus fructose equals to sucrose. Then the disaccharides, a disaccharide is a sugar combined with the two monosaccharides units. The example of disaccharide is the sucrose, lactose and maltose. Sucrose means glucose plus fructose, lactose means galactose plus glucose, and maltose is two units of glucose. And these two groups combine with a one glycosidic linkage. Now the oligosaccharide, we know that the when the monosaccharides contain 3 to 9 units of monosaccharides joined by the glycosidic bonds, it is called the oligosaccharides. Raffinose, if you see the structures, galactose, glucose and fructose which attach together within a glycosidic bonds. It is the example of oligosaccharide. Now polysaccharide, it is the starch is a most important of these units in the example of polysaccharides, because it contains more than 9, and starch has a 2 parts, that is amylose and amylopectins, and both are linked together 1,4 glycosidic bonds in amylose and amylopectin. Starch is a mixture of 2 large polymers, amylose and which consists of a linear chain of glucose, and amylopectin which is a highly branched polymer within a higher molecular weight. The structure of starch is shown in figures. Glycogen also has a structure of similar. The being that the chain are shorter and then the more branches, polysaccharide, polyhydroxylose and alanine are the type of glucose and fructose. Now my next slide I will be discuss on the another topics of carbohydrates, that is the functional properties, the physicochemical properties, and the starch also. This is whatever I will discuss in my next slides. Okay, thank you.